Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and today we'll take a look at how to make the karaoke bouncing ball effect seen at the start of this video using Final Cut Pro. Let's get started. First thing you need to do is, if you want, add a background to your video. You can use a video clip, or what we'll do for this demo is just use one of Final Cut Pro's built-in generators. Select your background and drag and drop it down into your timeline. Go back to the media browser, select the song you want to use, and press Q to connect it to your timeline. Press Shift-Z to see your entire timeline, and ripple trim your generator clip to the same length as your song. Zoom in on your timeline again, and change the timeline view to audio waveforms. Skim your clip, and find a spot where the lyrics start. Place your playhead there, and press Ctrl-T to add a basic title to your timeline. In the text inspector, type out the first line of your song and adjust the appearance and position of your text. Play back your clip, you touch me. Pause it where the lyric line ends, and ripple trim your title clip. Select your title clip, hold down the Option key, and drag it to the right to make a copy of it for the second line. By making a copy of it, all their styling and position options remain the same. All we need to do is change the text. Position your second title clip over the next line in your song, and up in the inspector, replace the text. Repeat this for every line in your song. To keep this video short, I'll only do a few lines. For our next step, we'll add the color text effect and animate it with the lyrics. Go back to your first title clip, make another copy of it, and layer it directly above the original. In the inspector window, change the color of your text to something different. Use the audio waveforms to help you find where the lyrics start, place your playhead there, and press the left arrow key to go back one frame. From the drop-down menu, select the trim tool, and use the middle control point on the right-hand side to trim your clip until no colored text is visible. Add a keyframe here. Press the right arrow key to move ahead one frame, and use the same trim handle to reveal the first syllable. Find where your next word or syllable starts, place your playhead there, and go back one frame. Add a keyframe. Move ahead one frame, and use the trim handle to reveal the next part. Depending on the timing of your song, you can do this one word at a time, or if it's slower, one syllable at a time. For mine, I'll use a combination of both, depending on the speed of the song. Repeat these steps for every line in your song. Here's what we have so far. You touch me so tenderly. If your timing seems off, you can always adjust the timing of your keyframes. Select the clip where the timing seems off, right-click on the clip, and select Show Video Animation. You can now click and drag these keyframes to adjust the timing to go with your song. Next, let's make and animate a bouncing ball. Move your playhead to the start of your first title clip, open the media browser, and select Titles and Generators. From the Generators drop-down menu, select Elements, and drag the shape generator down into your timeline. In the inspector, change the fill and outline colors of your shape, and use the outline width slider to make your outline nice and wide. Open the effects browser, and from the masks category, apply a shape mask to your generator clip. We'll use this to add a glowing effect to our ball. Drag the green control handles in the viewer to line them up with the inner circle, and the white control handle all the way to the right to make your mask perfectly round. Next, click and drag the outside ring of your mask to add some feather, making the ball look like it's glowing. Zoom out on your timeline, and ripple trim the generator clip over all your lyrics. From the drop-down menu under the viewer, select the Transform tool, and resize and reposition your ball above the text. Place your playhead at the end of the first title clip, and with the generator clip selected, press Command-B to blade it. Blade your generator clip on every line of the song. Go back to the start of your song, zoom in on your timeline, Select the top title clip and press Ctrl-V to show video animation. We'll use these keyframes to help us time the ball animation. Place your playhead on the second keyframe in the first group of keyframes. Select the generator clip and from the drop-down menu, select the transform tool. Hold down the shift key and drag your ball to the left until it's centered over the first ward. Holding down the shift key ensures you move in a straight line. Add a keyframe here to the transform parameter. Move your playhead to the start of the clip and drag the ball up and to the left until it's just off screen. By default, when you animate the transform tool, the animation moves in a straight line from point A to point B. To make our ball look like it's bouncing, we need to curve this line. Right-click on the first keyframe and click anywhere outside the pop-up to close it. Doing this reveals another control handle, a little red dot with a white outline extending from the keyframe. This control point allows us to add a curve to the animation path indicated by the red line in the viewer. Now, instead of going straight from point A to point B, our animation follows the path of this line. Move your playhead to the last keyframe in the second group, hold down the shift key, and move the ball to the center of the second colored ward. Right-click on the keyframe to reveal a path curve control point, and adjust it until you have a nice arc between the points. Move your playhead to the next group of control points, reposition your ball, right-click on the keyframe, and curve the path to make a nice arc. To make the ball pause on the last ward for a few frames before bouncing off screen, move the playhead ahead a few frames and add a keyframe to the transform parameter again. Press the down arrow key to move your playhead to the end of your clip, left arrow to go back one frame, and move the ball up and to the right until it's off screen. Right-click on the keyframe and curve the animation path. Click done and move on to your next generator clip. Repeat these steps for your entire song. Once done, here's our finished result. You touch me so tenderly. I want you tremendously. My heart knows no remedy. I don't know no remedy. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please share this with someone else who might enjoy it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.